give themselves present themselves faultless unto the Lord, which is the reasonable service, and not to think of yourself more highly than you ought. Some apostasy in the church, and I'm aware when Paul was telling them that Jesus was coming back, there was some folks down, shame, like the scoffers did, over in 2 Peter and chapter 3, they say that they've been talking about he's coming back for years. I remember when I was a child, the preacher used to say, the time is at hand, ready, we still have come. There are some folks that don't believe in God. There are some folks who deny that Jesus, the Word of God, manifested in the flesh. There were some folks who were in the church that had turned their backs on God. Can I tell you how close are you getting on? Do you not see that there are some folks way back then, you saw them, that know nothing under the sun. There were folks back then who denied God, who rebelled against God. There are folks today who deny Jesus, who rebelled against Jesus. And I need to tell you, there were some folks who didn't believe that God is God. They got all out in his hands. They were tearing up the church. And the church was getting divided. And some folks were doubting and did not believe. There were some folks talking about death in the end. There's no such thing as the resurrection. And some folks started scratching their head. And they were wondering, is it real? I don't know where my home's gonna be. Hell or hell, I got my some that will come and say that Jesus, Matthew 24, coming in the name of false teachers, false prophets, they're going to be wars and rumors of wars. They're going to be earthquakes in the right close only your own eyes. Hear the same now, the look of men now, go west cold now, why the church don't pass, we got the look of men now, the past cold now, can't take you now, we got the false teachers and false preachers, we're living in high, I hear the same now, the end high, we're not yet high, this is only the beginning high, we're living in high, Paul said high, it won't come high, till there be a great high, falling away high. We're living falling away now. People don't pray like they used to pray now. People don't sing like they used to sing now. People don't come like they used to come now. They're the great falling away now. How close are you to home now? Can I take now? We're almost home now. I can see you now, now. But when I get there, now, when I get there, now, I'm gonna be now. Over there. No more crying, no more hurting, no more sickness, over that night, we'll be saints. Yeah. them up? Are you lifting them up? I don't mean you're lifting up their cross. Like this one right here. Let them people know the folk know that God didn't die on the cross. But when he died on the cross, he didn't stay dead. See, does that matter when he died on the cross? When they stripped him out and they nailed his hands. When they nailed his feet. And lifted him up. He didn't die right there. But he looked down upon the people. And he cried out, Eli! And that's what I'm gonna Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. He asked the Lord, why hast thou forsaken me? You know, the sun refused to shine. The grave, they opened up. And a lot of the saints of God got him out of the grave. And they were watching all around. I don't know about you, but in that grave getting up morning, I want to be in the north. I want to be one of them that's marching in the north. I want to be one of them that's clothed in a white robe. I want to be one of them that's going to put on a crown of righteousness. And you call it out. Until that time, I know that the storm is passing over. Amen. May God bless you. Listen. All preachers said, give the preacher your hand. But give God your heart. Amen. Now, if there's anyone here who have not yet accepted Christ Jesus as your Savior, give the preacher your hand. Give God your heart. Amen. If you know of anyone that has not yet accepted Christ as their Savior, who are not walking with God, it's your job to go ye therefore and be a witness, to tell everybody about somebody who can save anybody. It's your job to provoke them unto the love of God. It's your job to tell them to love God with all your heart, all your mind, and all your soul. It's your job to tell them that they should love their neighbors as they love themselves. It's your job to tell them not to forsake the assembling of themselves together in the house of the Lord. To be one body in Christ means for all of us. Amen.